Okay folks, welcome back to another video here on Keep Productive. If you're brand new to Keep Productive, make sure to subscribe. Now, as you can imagine, Things is a very popular task management application. It's available for Mac, iOS, including iPad and iPhone. Now, it has just released a fairly big update, and it's rolling out on Mac at least December 16th. They launched this quick find update. And essentially, this does a few things for the service. Now, essentially, what it does is it adds these, I guess, new types of lists or views where you can sort of expand on your existing information. Let me go through them with you, and obviously this might be quite helpful if you're already a Things 3 user. Now, if you aren't a Things 3 user, we do have videos on that. I'll make sure to include them below. But the new views are as follows. You've got tomorrow, and that's a brand new view because you could only see that inside of the upcoming view, which was, I guess, a bit distorted by the other tasks. So you can now go to the quick find, go and type in tomorrow, and you'll find all the information there. And just a note on that quick find, it will now obviously remember what you recently went to. So you can now quickly go back to those pages if you want to. And the great thing is you can see all of tomorrow's tasks and events, as well as labels in one place. You can also do that with all projects. This is something I think a lot of people wanted to be able to see. So like a holistical view without actually having to look at it down the sidebar. And I think this will be very useful for those who are actually looking to see all their projects at once. I know a lot of people have projects that sort of are massively long on that left-hand side. And then you've also got logged projects. So you can now go see this view called log projects, allowing you to see ones that have been completed in the past. Now, I can also see, or you can also see, ones that are repeating. So, for example, if you've got things like meditation, reviewing expenses, water plants, you can now get them repeating and see them all in a view. So you can see sort of like things that are routine, and you can maybe get sort of ahead of the game by jumping in and actually completing them ahead of time. You've also now got deadlines as well. So if you type in deadlines, you get this view that you can see overdue stuff. And for example, you can also see, say there's some stuff in December. You can see stuff that is, I guess, flagged for coming up soon. So you can see just everything that's going to be in your immediate attention all in one place. So the other thing that you can do is you can type in on the quick find settings, which will allow you to get the settings area instead of having to actually find stuff. So they've also got the recent thing, but that also applies to projects as well. So if you recently went on the project, you can find that project pretty instantly, as well as quick find for headings as well. So if you want to find a heading inside of a specific thing like preparations for run a marathon, you can find that all there. Now, they've also added a few other updates. I won't go into detail on them. I'll mention a few. On the Mac, you can now hold down the command when clicking a link to open it in the background, which is pretty cool. On the Mac, you'll be able to, when inside an area or the new all projects list, you can now insert a project with a button in the toolbar or touch bar, which is pretty neat. So there are a few things that I guess make it a little bit easier to use. Things 3. Now they're on 11, which is pretty impressive, and they always seem to be updating it on a fairly routine basis. So guys, if you want to find out more about Things 3, you can find that all in the details below, but I hope you wish you a happy holiday, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Make sure you're subscribed if you're brand new, and a big thanks here from Keep Productive.